Did you read for John Ross initially? Is that the part you were going for?
Yeah, and for me, you know, we didn't know really where these characters were going. All we had was the pilot script. But I was so excited to play J.R.'s son. I mean, it was just like the best opportunity ever for a young male actor. So it was the role that I wanted, and man, I was just lucky and fortunate enough to get it.
Well, they're huge shoes to fill.
They are. I knew that there was a ton of expectation, you know, a lot of weight on my shoulders, which in a way, you know, it was kind of nice to be intimidated a little bit, you know, once I was cast, I knew that, you know, now game is on, and it's time to step up and really push myself because of how much expectation I knew that there would be from the original fans of the show. So for me, it was just like, take yourself somewhere else, create this guy, go crazy, and live, you know, live. Who is John Ross now? Who would the spawn of JR, who would JR's son, who would he be now coming into manhood, I guess? And that was a fun process, figuring that out.
Can you tell us how you and Larry developed your father-son dynamic?
You know, it was, I knew that the whole JR, like him coming and portraying JR again was gonna be a very kind of magical, intense thing. And I needed to just kind of hop on his, you know, his train and really kind of try and bring my stakes up to make this whole father-son, because there's a lot of backstory to these guys, you know. JR wasn't a great father. He was very, very business driven, and he didn't think about a lot of, you know, other things. Like, he cared about his family, but it was really money, power, oil, that was number one. And Sue Ellen had her issues, and so he didn't have a great relationship with either parent. So there was a lot of backstory to work on. There was a lot of things to really bring to, you know, me as an actor to portray through John Ross. And so the kind of the animosity towards my father, JR, was really there, and it was real. And it just kind of worked. We just kind of, from day one, you know, as soon as he opened his eyes and said his first line as JR, it was like, whoa, game on.
Yeah. Let's talk a little bit about John Ross and where he is now. Obviously, he's a grown up.
Yep.
How does he play into this new storyline?
You know, John Ross, he is now at I think in his mind, a very crucial part of his life. He's coming into manhood. He's really trying to make his presence known. He was born into this Ewing family. He feels that, you know, the Southfork and everything else is kind of his right, his birthright. And so he wants to prove himself to his father, even though he doesn't have an amazing relationship with him. He really wants to prove himself as an oil man, as a successful kind of young, smart, cunning businessman. And he really kind of prides himself on walking in JR's footsteps a little bit and doing business like JR did. So he's, you know, he's in love. He's very much in love with Elena, but also he sees everyone around him as kind of a chess piece a little bit. And right now it's a very crucial part of his game to make the right moves, get the right people on his side to be the man sitting at the head of the table at Southfork. So it's a big deal for John Ross right now, and it's a big moment, as you see in the very beginning of the pilot. Excitement right from the get-go.
Now, you say he's very much in love with Elena. That's definitely, I would say, debatable in the first, the early stages.
Fair.
How do you see that relationship progressing?
You know, Christopher, John Ross's cousin, Elena and John Ross, they've grown up together. They've been very close. He truly cares for Elena. He really does. You know, he's kind of fallen in love with her over the years. And obviously there's a backstory there. You know, there's a lot of history between the three of them. And that comes to a head now, where we're at now on the Dallas show. And it's an intense kind of love triangle storyline. And at the end of the day, you know, he's not a terrible person. He's very passionate about oil and about the Ewing name and legacy. And he might say things to other people and be doing things with other people, but it really is about the game and about getting himself closer to where he wants to be. At the end of the day, he really does truly care for Elena, and he's in love. And I think it's tough for him to, have a healthy relationship in the way that he does business right now in his life. So.
You said that he's obviously a very ambitious character. Do you think that there's any place where he would draw the line when it comes to business?
I think there is, you know, and you might see that, you will see that in the first season, you know, some things and hesitations that he has. He does have a heart. He cares about his family. Business is very, very important, but he definitely has a soft spot, and it's kind of this whole thing where the Ewings kind of are at each other's throats, and but at the end of the day, they're family, and if you mess with family, you know, you're gonna get the raw end of the stick, basically. And he truly believes that. So I think that, you know, our main goal was, original Dallas fans, please come back, because it's the same show, just 20 years later, same drama, same, you know, there's a lot of sex and backstabbing and things that make great television. And our main goal is to make the fans happy.
Before I let you go, how would you say that the show is going to bridge the gap between old fans and new viewers?
You know, we have everything about the original show to kind of satisfy the original fans. And I've showed the first few episodes to friends of mine that are younger, that were not even born when the show ended, that the writers did a great job of, even if you've never seen or heard of Dallas, you'll be able to jump, you watch the pilot and you're jumping right on board to the storylines, and it all makes sense and you get it and you fall in love with what's going on and kind of can't get enough of it. So I think that there's something for everybody, and you know, hopefully the younger generation, we can kind of bring our fans into something that they might not be familiar with, and that's our goal. And then to have the old fans come back, that's all we care about.